I just love spending time in Lightroom editing my photos, so I thought I would share with you my three favorite features in Lightroom, how you can use them to edit your photos in a better and maybe even a little bit faster way. So let's dig in, shall we? I could do this all day. Auto is just amazing. I think it's one of those features that will save me the most amount of time during a day of edit, actually. Let's undo auto. I will show you my second favorite Lightroom feature, which is the radial filter. It's Shift M on the keyboard or just click the filter in the toolbar. Point and drag to add your filter. Press O on your keyboard to show what the filter will affect. The feather slider will influence the softness of the edge of the filter. You can also invert the filter if you want to affect the inside of the circle. But let's affect the outside and do some basic adjustments. I will drag down saturation and clarity just to sort of tone down the outside of my radial filter. You can also stack filters. So I'll make an example. I'll just drag a small radial filter and by sort of moving this around, you can see that by increasing saturation and invert the filter, I can sort of influence spots of an image. Oops, let me invert that one. So you can influence sort of details of the image. And I think that is sort of the whole purpose of sort of attacking an image with filters. We need to think layers and details. There is no sort of basic adjustment for the overall image. Let me delete the radial filter and we will start over and apply what we just learned and make this image into something memorable. So I'll add auto again. I'll add radial filter and I'll drag down clarity, saturation and sharpness. That way we are sort of drawn into the circle, into the center of this image. And that's sort of what I wanted when I took the photograph. I'll add a second radial filter on top of the first one, and this filter I'm going to invert so I can influence the inside of the circle. So by adding some basic adjustments, I will sort of make the center of the image pop, because that's where I want you to look. And that's where we have the sharpness and that's where we have the saturation. And by increasing temperature and sharpness, we will add even more focus to the center of the image. The before and after, you will see that it's a completely different image with just two radial filters on basic adjustments. The sky is a little bit dull. There's no contrast in the sky, so I'll just add a third radial filter. I will rotate the filter a little bit. And yes, you can rotate filters. I'm hitting on my keyboard just to reveal where the filter is affecting the image. I realize I need to invert the filter to actually affect the sky. Adjusting clarity and dehaze, we will get the sky to pop as well. That's not a bad result for three basic filter and one auto adjustment. That was amazing, right? Auto settings and radial filter. That's two of my three favorite features of Lightroom. And with auto and just three radial filter, we turned that okay photograph into a really memorable photograph. But we are far from done. So I even think you should strap in for this last one because it's gonna just... I think I better show you. So back to the computer. Let me turn off before and after and switch image for this next part. I'll just start to do some basic cropping. 4x5, because I plan to use this on Instagram. I'm gonna center the tram tracks. And we are, as previously, gonna use auto. So I'm hitting auto. And this is not a bad image, but we need some focus to the center of the image. So I'll drag out an oval radial filter. I'm gonna drag down exposure just to make everything but the tram darker. I think we should go a little bit darker. So I'll just click my radial filter and drag down exposure a little bit. Looks much better. We need some focus to the tram and the eyes will be drawn to lighter part of the image. I will drag another oval radial filter in place on the asphalt in front of the tram and I will start to sort of do some adjustments on saturation, highlights, whites and blacks. But by pressing O on my keyboard, you will also notice that by doing this, I will make the tram affected as well. And it doesn't look good. Ob- obviously. But here's a twist to the radial filter and actually to all filters in Lightroom. On your upper right, you actually have an option that says brush. That will bring out the brush adjustment for that filter. By pressing Alt on our keyboard, it will become the subtraction brush. You can adjust the size of the brush very quickly by just rolling your mouse. And if we are holding Shift and scrolling on our mouse, we can affect the feather. So let's go back to our radial filter and see what happens if I take a big brush and then I'll just start to take away from my oval radial filter and I'll just sort of paint away. I'll track the edges of the rail. Oh, let's follow it one more time. It starts to look good. I think that looks good. I will hit the O on my keyboard to show the effect of the filter. Suddenly the asphalt is much lighter. It will sort of correlate with the headlights of the tram. Now I will add some other adjustment just to make it pop a little bit more and some final sharpness to bring out the texture. Radial filters are amazing, but sometimes we need a little bit more precision. It's time for my third favorite feature. Now when we know about brushes and radial filters, we could actually use a radial filter to make this tram pop, which I think will be the final effect to make this image complete. So if I add a filter, invert it, bring out my brush, press Alt to start to sort of take away from the filter to sort of affect the tram, it could be a viable solution, but it's a little bit too blunt. And the solution is actually adjustment brush. It works exactly as the brush in relation to the filter, but we don't need the filter. The brush will be the filter and we have much more control to what we are doing. So I'm going to hit space on the keyboard to zoom in on the image and I'll start to add to the tram to sort of mask it so we can make adjustment to make it pop. But I'm sure if you're noticing, this mask doesn't look really good, does it, right? It's a little bit spotty almost. And there's a reasonable explanation for this, and I think that I actually need to explain something that people get wrong, and that's the difference between density and flow. So let's set it to density 100 but flow 50. So if I keep sort of painting on my adjustment on top of each other, it will become thicker and thicker and thicker until it hits density 100. But if instead I change to density 50 and flow 100, it doesn't matter how much I keep adding because it will never go above my set density, in this case 50. So I'll set my density to 60% and my flow to 100, and let's start to sort of mask the tram so we can make the proper adjustment. And just let me show you one last thing that will blow your mind, and that's when you use the key Shift. So let's click with a mask, then hold Shift and click along a straight line. It's like magic. That way you can actually add masks perfectly straight with just two clicks. So let's just keep doing that and sort of mask the tram. And I don't mind if I'm sort of adding a little bit too much of a mask in the shadow area. I will press Alt to change the flow on my subtraction. That way I can start to sort of take away from my mask more gently. And I think this is a better way. It gives you more control and it's a faster workflow. So I will add as quick as I can, and then I will have a softer adjustment brush to sort of take away in the areas where I haven't added or masked perfectly. That way we can also sort of add different strength of the mask within the same mask. Let me show you here on the roof. I'll add the mask, it's density 60, and then with the adjustment brush I can just start to take away a little bit. Now when we start to make the adjustment to the tram to make it pop, where we increase exposure and the highlights and adjusting the shadows, we have perfect control. I would show you before and after. I mean, the tram just pops. It's amazing. But wait, we are not done. Let me show you one final thing with the adjustment brush that I think is mind-blowing. Just look at this. By using the adjustment brush with a bigger size and then use a smaller brush, holding Shift and clicking, we will mask an entire triangular area with just two clicks. Then I can switch to my softer subtraction brush, feather out the end of the area. I will just tidy up the mask, hit O on the keyboard to hide the mask, and I can make the proper adjustment, like lowering the exposure to darken the edge of the image, and we are done. Just look at this image. It's amazing. This was my three favorite features in Lightroom. I hope this helps you get more out of Lightroom and increase the quality of your photos without spending unnecessary time looking for features. And as always, thank you very much for watching. Until next time.